Hello, my name is Alexander. I decided to record a short video on how to properly install a circulation pump and where it is more appropriate to install it, on the supply or return line. After all, these are age-old disputes, and many people are mistaken when they say that a circulation pump must be installed exclusively on the return. These people argue that the temperature is lower on the return, which leads to a longer service life of the circulation pump. But this is a misconception, incorrect, given that the temperature regime specified on the circulation pump, that is, we can perfectly see it on the box itself, is 110 degrees Celsius. And an extra 5, 10, 20 degrees practically play no role in the pump's service life. And if you need to install the pump on the supply, you can do so without any hesitation. There are no restrictions or prohibitive regulations. The only thing, I carefully read the manual for all circulation pumps, including Grundfos and Wilo. And you know, I read about Wilo. And I read about Valtec. This is the only company that writes that, to increase the service life of the pump, it needs to be installed on the return. But they do not regulate this. These are just recommendations. You can install the pump either on the supply or the return. They just tell you what is better to do, and that's it. Also, there are certain types of smart Alex who start explaining to me, or rather, do not start explaining, but just say that the pump creates a vacuum on the return. Unfortunately, when you ask them and try to understand, how does the pump create a vacuum? They cannot say anything coherent. And they cannot explain anything either. They just say that the pump creates a vacuum. Therefore, you can also, in principle, ignore these arguments and install the pump however you like. So the circulation pump must always be positioned after the expansion tank, as the circulation pump creates pressure after itself, meaning the pressure before the pump is less than the pressure after the pump. And correspondingly, when the circulation pump is turned on, imagine that we have an expansion tank right here. In this way, roughly speaking, it sucks the liquid from the expansion tank, supplying everything to the heating system. In this case, the expansion tank works much more efficiently, much better. If the expansion tank is placed before the circulation pump, then when the circulation pump is turned on, it begins to pressurize into the expansion tank, filling it with a heat carrier. For the expansion tank, this is, in principle, not necessary, and it reduces its efficiency. Also, it is necessary to install the circulation pump between the heating device, that is, the boiler, and the first radiator. If we install the pump between radiators, then the heat carrier going through the supply pipe will bypass the radiator that is installed before the pump. That is, it will just fly through the pipe like this and go to the next radiator. And because it makes no sense for it to rise into the radiator that is before the pump. Therefore, it is mandatory to install the pump between the boiler and the first heating device. And by the way, the situation, as I just described, where the pump is installed between two radiators. It often occurs in my practice when people's last radiators do not heat. They think that if they install some additional pump on the last radiator, it will magically start heating. The radiator, of course, this one will start heating, but the ones before it, radiators, they simply will not receive heat, as it will just pass by like this through the supply pipe. Also, I would like to draw attention to the fact that many large companies, such as Meebs, Stout, S. Barberi, install the circulation pump on the supply in their mixing groups. And I think there are smart people sitting there who make all the technical calculations, calculations for the pump's service life. I would, being a circulation pump, still try to install it on the return if you have such an opportunity, if it is convenient and can be done that way. I would proceed as follows. First, we would have the last radiator, then there would be the expansion tank, and then the circulation pump. After the circulation pump, respectively, the boiler. I would also like to note that when installing a circulation pump according to all the rules, it is necessary to install two valves that will be installed. That is, one valve will be before the pump, another will be after the pump. Valves can be used without detachable connections, as we have these so-called union nuts on the pump. And also, according to the rules, it is still necessary to install a filter. Also, a bit of general information on how it is necessary to install and how the pump can be installed. The pump must be installed so that its rotor is in a horizontal position. Rotor, this is this part. That is, now it is in a horizontal position. It can be installed like this, like this, like this, like this, and like this. It is forbidden to install it so that the rotor is not in a horizontal position. That is, in this way. Otherwise, we will have air ingress, and the pump can quickly fail. It is also forbidden to install the pump in this way. The same thing, we will have air ingress, we will not be able to vent the air from the pump, and it will quickly fail. Another feature is that it is forbidden to install the pump in such a way that the terminal box is below, is under the pump. Because when you start to vent the air from the pump, and all the heat carrier will flow to the terminal box, which will lead to a short circuit. Therefore, in principle, you can unscrew this 4-hexagon and rearrange it in this way the whole head of the pump, so that the terminal box is on top. I try to explain as simply and as clearly as possible about the recommendations for installing a circulation pump. Thank you all for watching. Like, comment, don't be shy. Subscribe to our channel. Bye.